I am Esha De. I was Mukhopadhyay. That was my maiden surname. And Vivekananda Mukhopadhyay is my father. My father actually got very enthused about Bangladesh Liberation War because he was born, first of all, in Bangladesh. He was born in Faridpur district, 1904. And he left Bangladesh very early in his life. See, he wanted to be a journalist. He wanted to write. So he went to Calcutta at a very early age, and then he became very famous, etc. But he had not, he did not visit Bangladesh, or Purwabongo as it was called then. He did not visit, especially after independence, because Pakistan government did not allow him to visit his homeland. I believe he was a kind of persona non grata, because in those days he was a nationalist. He was a nationalist and he belonged to the leftist wing of Congress, so to say. Ideologically, I mean, ideologically. So he was against partition. For all these reasons, he was a persona non grata. So when in 1971, almost 50 years after he left Bangladesh, so when this liberation war started, in fact, before the liberation war in 1952 language movement, my father saw this was the beginning, perhaps the beginning of a long struggle or a beginning of a new awakening. That is how he perceived it. So in 1970-71, when these problems started, he was very much inspired, although he was then 67 years old. So his first object was, first of all, to inspire the young men in West Bengal to form a brigade. He said, "Ek lakh torun toiri hao, Bangladesher jonno rokto dite hobe." These words are all there in these articles. Tomader to rokto dite hobe. And this is how he enthused people. He was incidentally a very famous speaker. He was an orator. Bengal had a long tradition of oratory in 19th century. He is the last of that tradition. So he also held meetings, spoke in meetings, and enthused people. And this actually has something to do with the contemporary situation in West Bengal. See, West Bengal was at that time in a very bad shape, because we had a continuous, you see, flux of refugees from this side, and there was a terrible law and order problem, food problem. So there's complete anarchy. So father thought this new movement in Bangladesh will influence the people and young men of West Bengal to get out of this negative, you know, negative attitude which they were developing. So this has also something to do with India. So it was not only for Bangladesh, as my father continuously said, it is not only a liberation for Bangladesh, it is always a new chapter for Bengal, West Bengal and India. We'll be entering a new age. And then his second, you see, object was to make Bangladesh recognized. He went on asking Mrs. Gandhi, particularly central government, recognize Bangladesh as soon as possible, because he was an incidentally an expert on war. He had written an authoritative 2 volumes of work on the Second World War in Bengali. It is unique in Indian languages. No one else can, I mean, in this field compete with him. So he was very conversant with martial affairs. So he said that it is not possible for the people of Bangladesh to fight with Pakistan unless they get military help from India. Pakistan was a different government, different state. So in government of India just cannot send a military expedition like that. There has to be a sizable public opinion in favor of such military expedition, particularly in India. So my father was, you may say, working on that field. And then after the recognition, my father actually predicted a long struggle, because Pakistan was making all sorts of, you know, poses. They were saying they will go on fighting, this, that. So we thought that perhaps they are really very prepared and they are going to fight for a long time. And Pakistan was also banking on the support from China. This my father has from the very beginning said, China is against India, China is supporting Pakistan, but China will not lift a finger to help Pakistan in this war. They will never cross Himalayas to fight someone else's war. China will never do it. So, and he was proved to be right, and he was also very critical of United States, because many people, journalists and all that, they're already collecting information of Bangladesh war, and yet the government was not responding as they should have, as they as expected from them. So my father was also very critical of America. And the third thing which he did, because he was not only a journalist, he was also the president of Indo-Soviet Friendship Society. He was the president of Peace Council. So he had a sort of standing, so to say. So he also asked Soviet Union to support government of India in their policy towards Bangladesh, to befriend Bangladesh. And then as a president of the Peace Council, when he went abroad, I believe the meeting was in Helsinki. So there he got the international community, he and other, you see, Indian delegates, to inform the international community about the atrocities that was going on in Bangladesh. And there, I believe, they passed in the unanimous resolution supporting Bangladesh in Helsinki. So that was also something which my father did. So his actually role was not organizing reporters to come to Bangladesh or to border, because that was being done actually in every newspaper. Every newspaper in India, not only in West Bengal, but in other parts of India, were very keen on reporting Bangladesh war. So my father was actually trying to influence or playing his little role in forming the policy of government of India towards Bangladesh and the foreign governments to befriend, you see, India in this effort. Bangladesh war is not exactly a war which affected only Bengalis, but it affected, in fact, all Indians, I find, all Indians. Especially on the violation of human rights by Pakistan. And then something also on, you see, on Bengali nationalism, but the language-based nationalism was a factor for him, but the greater factor for him was the secular aspect. Because it is the religion, the religious aspect, which had posed many problems for us. So for him, a secular democratic Bangladesh was the aim of the struggle. He always mentioned this secular, democratic, and progressive Bangladesh was his, you may say, ideal, which he wanted to achieve. And of course, you may say he thought that people of Bangladesh were striving towards that ideal. And so he supported the struggle wholeheartedly. I sometimes try to think how he would feel, suppose he is here today. I have not seen Dhaka before. This is my first visit. But if my father had come, naturally he would have been overwhelmed. I think he would have been overwhelmed. Because for him, East Bengal was a very backward place, and he was very sorry for it, he suffered for it, and he said that it was something ought to be done about it. So he would have been very happy. But so far as the award is concerned, of course he would be happy to receive the award, or he would be happy to know that he was being honored. But he was sort of stoic, you know. He did not do anything for a reward or in order to get anything. See, he thought it was his duty, so he did it. It is sort of missionary zeal, as I said. So the expectation of honor or expectation of award actually never entered his mind, if I may say so. So actually, I was thinking about it last night, that this lavish hospitality that I have received, which I have not done anything, I have received only as a daughter of my father. And father, who was stoic, who never had much money in his life, he suffered for his poverty, and I am being lavishly entertained by Bangladesh, the new state, which he wanted to help to form. This is, I think, a sort of irony. There is an ironical part in it.